So you have been prescribed spironolactone and you're wondering what can be the side effects. Stay tuned because I'm going to be going through them in this video. Now, before I start, make sure that you like this video, subscribe to my channel and comment down below if you want me to make a video about any particular subject or if you found any valuable tips in this video as well. Now, if you have been prescribed spironolactone and that's what brought you to this video, you probably have symptoms of hyperandrogenism and you probably have diagnosed high levels of testosterone. So if you've been prescribed spironolactone for PCOS, for your hormonal imbalances, you're probably going to have it prescribed with birth control. Now, let's go through spironolactone side effects. Now, before I'm going to start talking about them, you need to know that spironolactone is actually medicine that was created for something completely different. So this is called a water pill. So it is helping with liquid balance in your body with at the same time sparing potassium in your body. So what it does, it decreases probably sodium levels, it decreases your blood pressure because it's used for high blood pressure and for edemas and stuff like that. But what is special about this drug is that it also doesn't get rid of potassium in your body. It's supposed to spare it, which helps with liquid balance. This is a completely different video and I could talk about diuretics completely separately, but you need to know that this medication that has been prescribed to you to lower testosterone levels does that at all, because some of the side effects are connected to that. So three big things that might happen when you are actually taking spironolactone is, due to the fact that what I just said, that you are gonna have very high levels of potassium that can be not very good for your body. Electrolyte balance is a very, very sensitive balance. So all your electrolytes like potassium, magnesium, calcium, and sodium have to be in balance for you not to have any bad symptoms. So bad symptoms might be kidney problems, they might be dizziness, there might be nausea, there might be headaches. There's plenty of dehydration or electrolyte imbalance symptoms. So having extremely high levels of potassium can even be fatal. So this is one of the major side effects of spironolactone, and this is why this is not medication to be treated lightly. So the second symptom might be actually enlarged breasts. And if you're taking spironolactone and you're noticing that happening, this can also indicate very, very serious problems. So if you start noticing that your breasts are getting enlarged, you should contact your doctor as soon as possible. The third thing is lowering blood pressure and actually decreased kidney function. So again, because spironolactone is influencing our electrolytes in our body, it can influence our kidneys in a very, very negative way. So make sure that if you notice that your blood pressure is getting lower or you have any associated symptoms, that you contact your doctor immediately. Now, let's talk about a little bit more milder symptoms and the symptoms that are very, very common and the symptoms that I actually have noticed on many PCOS groups. Now, I like actually going to PCOS groups on Facebook, for example, and reading what people really go through. I'm sure that that's how you got to this video as well. And most of people actually have quite mild side effects of spironolactone. Of course, it's not very, very common that we are gonna get, you know, fatal hyperpotassium levels or anything like that. So, what are the most common things? Now, I have my notes here, so I'm gonna be looking here. First of all are stomach problems. So, the most common is diarrhea and stomach cramping, nausea and vomiting, high potassium levels, of course, leg cramps, again, because it is diuretic, so it can actually cause electrolyte imbalance. So you might have not enough magnesium or sodium and stuff like that, or they might just be out of whack. Headaches, again, connected to electrolyte imbalances. Dizziness, same thing. Drowsiness, same thing. Itching. Itching, I'm guessing, might be because it might be a little bit toxic on the liver, like most of strong medicine. And if you have a problem with your liver, your whole skin is itchy. Or it can be also allergic reaction, but that is just my idea. Now, another thing is irregular menstrual cycles or bleeding after menopause, and that is connected with high testosterone levels. So you see, for people who take it actually for water retention, they might have problems with periods, but you are taking it because you already probably have high testosterone levels. So that should be the opposite. That should actually regulate it. Because for a person with healthy testosterone levels, if you decrease that level, that it might cause irregular cycles. But for a person with too high testosterone levels, when you lower them, they might actually come back, right? So I'm gonna go through a few more, and because the list is quite long. But you of course can have allergic reaction like to any medication. So if you notice any skin rash, hives, fever, trouble breathing, swelling and so on, this can be a reaction to any medication or actually anything that you eat or ingest. So of course you should contact the doctor. Typical for spironolactone is, as I said, electrolyte and fluid problems. So mouth dryness, extreme thirst, extreme weakness and tiredness, fast heart rate and dizziness, and not being able to urinate. So if you notice any sort of water related problems, that might be it. As well as, yeah, as I said, dizziness, low blood pressure and so on and so forth. Dangerously high potassium levels might include muscle weakness, not being able to move your legs and your arms, so extreme weakness, extreme tiredness, tingliness and numbness of your limbs, and slow heart rate. Another thing that I mentioned is breast enlargement, which is just growth of tissue in both males and females, if of course males are usually taking it probably for the water imbalances. Now you can also have skin reactions such as redness, blistering, peeling or loosening of your skin, including inside of your mouth. So as you can see, spironolactone is very, very strong medication and it is used for a variety of different reasons. As with any medication, I think that the medication should be last resort. So if you are looking to maybe supplements to lower your androgen levels, make sure you check my video and check my videos about insulin resistance, because especially if you have high androgen levels connected to insulin resistance in PCOS, there is a way to balance them naturally by diet and lifestyle that actually works. And if you see my skin at the moment, I have new camera, so you will be able to see it. It is far from perfect, but I have been struggling with quite a strong acne for 18 years. And now with diet and lifestyle, I don't have any active pimple. Maybe I have a little one here on my skin. That's because of shea butter that I can't use. But yeah, after struggling with acne for 18 years, I never had to take spironolactone. And I'm not saying that there are not people who should be taking it, because of course spironolactone can help your acne. It can help your hair loss and hirsutism, so excessive hair growth, which are very, very, you know, bad symptoms that can influence your mental health as well. So the medication is there for something, but make sure that if you go on spironolactone, combine it with lifestyle changes, so then eventually you can get off it and continue your life without harsh medication and with balanced hormones as well. Now let me know in the comments, are you using spironolactone? How did you feel? What were the side effects that maybe you were experiencing, or maybe you didn't experience any? And make sure you like, subscribe and click the notification bell to be notified about my future videos, and I'll see you very soon. Bye.